In this first set, we're going to multiply and we're going to simplify if possible. Let's look at our first example here. We have a to the seventh times a to the fifth. Now, the rule to remember is this. As long as the bases are the same as they are in this case here, all you have to do is add the exponents. So in this case, the base is a. We add 7 plus 5, 12. So a to the 7th times a to the 5th is a to the 12th. What's happening here is this a to the 7th represents 7 a's lined up. A to the 5th is 5 more. So how many do you have total? Well, you've got 7 a's and 5 more a's. You've got 12 a's total. That's why the rule is when you multiply these monomials, as long as the bases are the same, you simply add the exponents. Let's move on to our second problem. Here we have 3 to the 7th times 3 to the 4th power. Again, we identify the bases to be the same. They're both 3. So we write the 3, and how many 3's do we have? We have 7 plus 4, or 11. Let me caution you on this particular problem. Many students, when they see the base as a number, as it is in this case, feel tempted to multiply these two together and write this as 9. But if we wrote 9 here to the 11th power, we'd be incorrect because we don't have 11 nines, we have 11 threes. So be very cautious. For some reason, most students can do this problem okay, but when they see the numbers, they're tempted to multiply. Don't make that mistake. Let's look over at our third one here. We have a to the 3rd times b to the 2nd. Now remember, the rules on multiplying these monomials here is that first of all, the bases must be the same. Notice the first base is a, the second base is b. Very different from one another. So since they're different, we have to leave this one as is. We cannot simplify. It's right now in simplified form. Let's move on to a more complex problem. We have 2xy times negative 1/4 x square y times 6xy to the 3rd power. Don't feel overwhelmed at the length of this problem because we're going to take it step by step, and it'll actually be just as easy as simplifying these ones above. The first part is to just multiply the numbers together. We have 2 times 1/4, and let's not worry about the sign, we'll do that next. 2 times 1/4, which is 2/4, or 1/2, times 6, which is 3. I'll do that calculation one more time. 2 times 1/4, which is 2/4, or 1/2, times 6 is 3. Now, as I said, I'll take care of the sign right now. Remember, when we multiply a product, we count the number of negative signs. In this case, there's 1, so that gives us a negative product at the end. So we've taken care of that sign problem. Next, we're going to have to combine all the like bases. Here we have x. Now, when you don't see an exponent on the variable, we can assume that that exponent is 1. So let's go ahead and place 1's by every variable that does not show an exponent. Now we're going to use the same rule as we did up here. We're going to look at like bases. Here we have x to the 1st power, x to the 2nd power, and x to the 1st power. And remember, when we multiply, as we're doing here, all we have to do is to add the exponents. So 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 1 is 4. So we have x to the 4th power. Again, let's look at that. We have x to the 1st, x to the 2nd, and x to the 1st. Since we're multiplying this product, all we have to do is add the exponents. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 1 is 4, or simply x to the 4th power. Now let's finish off with our y's. We have y to the 1st, y to the 1st here, and y to the 3rd down here at the end. So again, the rule is simply this. When we're multiplying these variables, all we're going to do is add the exponents. 1 plus 1 is 2, plus 3 is 5. So that gives us y to the fifth power. So notice that if we take it step by step as we did, it really wasn't too bad. The product of these three is negative 3x to the fourth, y to the fifth. The key to these problems then, if you've noticed, is check to make sure that the bases are the same when you're multiplying. If they are the same, simply add the exponents. Don't be fooled. Make sure you check those bases carefully, because sometimes these types of problems will be thrown in to see if you recognize that those bases are different. Now let's see how our rules of exponents work when we divide. Let's divide the following expressions. Let's start with the one on the far left here. Notice we have 10 to the 13th power. If you can imagine, that's like having 13 tens all lined up across the row here. We have 10 to the 7th power. That's like having 7 tens all across the bottom here. If you think back to how we reduced fractions, we could just cross out all the common factors. Since we have 7 down here and 13 above, we would cancel the 7 with 7 of the 13 in the numerator, and that's what we'd have left. An easier way to do that than to go through that work every single time is simply to subtract the exponents. So in this case, we have 13 tens upstairs, 7 ten downstairs. What's going to happen is when we divide out 7 of the tens downstairs with 7 of the tens upstairs, we'll have 6 left over upstairs. So instead of going through that work every single time, all we have to do is subtract the 13 minus 7. Now the base stays the same. So that leaves it as 10, 13 minus 7, 6. And that's how we divide these exponents. 10 to the 13th divided by 10 to the 7th, 10 to the 6th. Let's try our next problem. We have x to the 11th divided by x. Now remember, when there's no exponent showing, we can assume that that exponent is 1. We're going to use the same procedure we did in the previous problem. Remember, this x to the 11 represents 11 x's in the numerator. This x to the first power represents 1 x in the denominator. We're going to divide out one of these here with 1 in the numerator, which would leave 10 in the numerator, or as we said, the rule is just keep that base x, 11 minus 1, 10. So we have x to the 10th power. Let's try one last problem over here. Now if you'll notice, the only difference is in these first two problems, the numbers for the exponents in the numerators were larger. In this third problem off to the left here, we have 31 as the exponent in the numerator and 56 in the denominator. So what does that mean? That means that we have more tens in the denominator than we do in the numerator. But that doesn't change much. All we have to do, if we can visualize, we would keep dividing out those tens. Once we ran out of tens in the numerator, we would still have some tens left in our denominator. So the rule is basically the same. Instead of subtracting 31 minus 56, we're going to instead do it in the other direction. We keep the base of 10. The 31 we're going to subtract from 56, or 56 minus 31, that's how many tens we have on our denominator. So 56 minus 31 is 25. So that leaves me 1 over 10 to the 25th. Now one rule I like to incorporate that helps me when I divide these exponents is the following. When I look at a problem and I recognize that those bases are the same, I look at the exponent and say to myself, which one's bigger, 13 or 7? In this case, I know that 13 is larger, which happens to be in the numerator. So what I do then is bring the 7 to the numerator, and in my mind I tell myself this little phrase, the big guy wins. 13's bigger, 7 has to go up. When 7 comes up, it becomes a negative 7. 13 minus 7 is 6. Similarly, over here, I look at my two exponents, 31 and 56. 56 is the big guy, so 31 has to come down where the big guy is. 56 minus 31 gives me 25. And notice it has to go wherever the big guy is. If the big guy is upstairs, we end up upstairs. If the big guy is downstairs, we end up in the downstairs. So just remember to subtract those exponents when you're dividing. Let's simplify an expression that has a lot of rules of exponents. We're going to simplify this complex looking expression, negative 2, x to the third, y to the 0, z, all over 4xz squared, all of this raised to the fifth power. Now the first step, if you'll remember, is we're going to raise to a power. And the rule for raising to a power is just to multiply those exponents. Don't forget that this 2 has an exponent of 1, the z has an exponent of 1, the 4, and the x as well. So we're going to raise all these to the first power, so it looks like this. Excuse me, all these to the fifth power, so it looks like this. Negative 2 to the fifth power, x to the 3 times 5, 15, y, now we have a 0 here, so 0 times 5 is 0, and then z to the 1 times 5, or 5. Let's go through that again. Now notice, one thing you have to be careful of here is the negative does go with the 2, and it's raised to the fifth power. So it looks like this, negative 2, 1 times 5, 5. X, 3 times 5, 15, 0 times 5, 0, and 1 times 5, 5. We're going to repeat the same procedure in our denominator. 4, and again the exponent 1, so 1 times 5 is 5. So we have 4 to the 5th power. X to the 1 times 5, 5. X to the 5th power. Z to the 2nd, raised to the 5th power, means 2 times 5, 10. So that leaves us with z to the 10th in the denominator. Now the rest of this is then to use our division rule for exponents. Let's first of all simplify the numbers that we have. We have negative 2 to the fifth power. This means that we have 5 negative signs, an odd number, so we know that our quotient is going to be negative at the end. So let's take care of that. So we have 2 to the fifth, which 2 to the fifth is 2 times 2, 4, times 2, 8, times 2, 16, times 2, 32. So we get 32 there. X to the 15th we'll leave as is for now. Now y to the 0. Remember the rule for exponents that any variable to the 0 power is 1. So this is just a 1, we don't have to show it anymore. And then let's continue down, z to the 5th. All over. Downstairs we have 4 to the 5th, and we know that 4 to the 5th is 1024. So we're going to write that down, 1024, x to the 5th, and z to the 10th. All right, now we can combine all these variables that have the same base by using our division rule. Well, let's first go ahead and take care of these numbers. 32 happens to be a factor of 1024. In fact, 32 times 32 is 1024. So 32 goes into itself once into 1024 32 times. So what do we have here? We have that negative sign. We don't want to forget about that. Here we have x to the 15th over x to the 5th. Again, the big guy wins. The big guy is upstairs at 15. When 5 goes upstairs, it becomes a negative 5. 15 minus 5, 10. So that gives me x to the 10th power. Let's look at the z's. We have z to the 5th over z to the 10th. The big guy is downstairs this time. When 5 goes downstairs, it becomes a negative 5. So we have 10 minus 5, or 5. And we don't want to forget about our 32 here that we got when we reduced that fraction. So here it is, our final simplification of this quite complex looking expression, negative x to the 10th over 32z to the 5th.